So I'm going to demonstrate how to do a waterfall braid, and I've seen it done a couple of different ways, so I'm going to try to explain the different ways that I know how. So first of all, you can start right here and include your bangs if you have them, and if not, just start at your part. Or if you have bangs, you can just put them down and start right here. Either way is good. I'm going to start and do my bangs. So, just take it, start like you're gonna do a little mini French braid. You have to know how to do a French braid for this. So if you don't, let's just figure that out first. So I broke into three pieces, and I'm just kind of braiding that. And adding in more hair as we go, like a normal French braid, taking from both the top and the bottom. I'm also doing it kind of loose because I don't want it to be like plastered flat against my head. Once I have like the bangs done, I'm gonna make sure and do one more. And then I'm gonna go ahead and start the waterfall. If you're skipping, if you don't have bangs or you're starting behind them, go ahead and just start the waterfall now. So, I'm gonna go ahead and add in a piece from the top, like a normal French braid, connecting those and twisting it in. Okay, so now, when I take this bottom piece, instead of just adding some hair and putting it in, there's two different ways to do it. You can just drop it and grab a new piece and put it in, or you can split it in half and drop half of it and just put the other half in. Okay, I like to kind of do both. So I'm gonna take this piece, I'm gonna split it in half. Well, more like 3/4. I'm gonna keep a third of it. Then I'm also gonna grab a new piece from underneath and put it in. Okay, then the top you do like normal. You grab some new hair. Put it in. Okay, the bottom one, I'm gonna drop it, just keep a little right there, just put it, grab a new chunk, put it in, this one, this braid to be kind of looser. It's more of a and as I'm getting back more, I'm getting bigger chunks because I do want it to go kind of all around my head. I'm getting back, so I have to turn. Splitting, dropping this piece, grabbing a new piece, and braiding that into the middle. Then, the top, I'm going to go ahead and put that in. Now, I've seen this ended two different ways. One, you can just go ahead and put on a small, clear rubber band and just kind of like rubber band it right there and let this piece fall down. You do like part of the waterfall. Or you can continue the braid and go all the way around, which is what I'm going to do now. Let's finish out the braid. normal. Stop this braid whenever you want. I have a small rubber band here on my finger. I like the little clear ones. I'm at the dollar store in like packs of 500. Okay, and then on. And then, so you can see this is the end of the braid, and I don't know how clear you can see the waterfall. There it is. That is how you do a waterfall braid.